What's going on, guys? Big Mike D717 Outlaw here with you today. We're going to be diving back into another video working on the bikes. If you don't remember from, I believe it was probably about a week and a half ago, we put the new Evil swing arm, 4-8 adjustable swing arm on the Busa to get it ready for one last race, which is coming up November 24th with Send It Steve. I think Street Speed 717, maybe Diablo Formula Racing might be showing up. I'm not 100% sure. I just know that this is my last chance of the season to get the Busa to break the 9-second mark after its first run at Maple Grove when we were running low 10s. We're just hoping that with the new swing arm I can launch it harder. But if you don't remember from that episode, we did have one minor problem. I put a fender eliminator kit on the bike, and it now with the swing arm, the tire is right underneath the new license plate bracket, and it rubs my rear tire. So I can't ride it like that because it's unsafe, especially if I launch. It's really going to suck the suspension up and make the tire really press against that bracket. So I went online, did a little bit of research, and figured out what I can do is to still keep a license plate on the bike, but keep it out of harm's way with the tire and I guess anything else from that rear swing arm that could possibly hit it. So what I decided to do is I went on cyclegear.com and ordered a speed metal swing arm bracket, license plate bracket. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna put this on the bike, and this should get the license plate out of the way, but still keep it visible for legal purposes so that way I don't get pulled over for no license plate on the bike. But we're gonna go ahead and get this installed, and the Busa will be ready for the track here in about 2 weeks. And yeah, we're just gonna go ahead and throw her together. All right, guys, so of course our first step here, we have to pull our original license plate bracket off. And unfortunately too, we also have to disconnect the license plate light. I will be getting new lights for this, but just for now, since we're just trying to get it ready for this race, I'm not going to worry about wiring a whole new light to this, because that means I'll have to put a hole possibly in the swing arm and run a wire through it just so it's a little bit cleaner. Don't really want to do that yet. I really just want to get this thing ready for the track. So let's get this fender eliminator kit off and get the new one on. All right, guys, well, we have our bracket off. We just did a little snip on the wires. I taped up so that way they don't short each other out, and put the wires, tuck them back inside this tail. Now, we're gonna go ahead and put we're probably gonna have to bend my plate to get it on the new bracket, but let's go ahead and get it done. All right, guys, well, this was kind of simple enough. You just kind of flex the plate just enough around this bracket, and yeah, put your screws in. That's about it. Well, we have our plate all ready to go, so now the fun part. We have to get the bolt off of the swing arm or off of the axle and go ahead and get this baby put on. Well, guys, I have to admit, I wasn't sure if I was going to like putting that on, but it looks a little bit better than I thought it was going to. It really cleans up the tail end of the bike, which, honestly, Busas have such a sexy line right there. Like, it cleans that up. To me, this looks so much nicer here. And, yeah, that's pretty much it. Just wanted to get that up. And the other thing, too, that kind of makes it nice with that is it almost doubles as a chain guard, because if that chain would ever give, it's gonna hit the back of the plate instead of launching it maybe directly behind me, and it'll just work. It should work as flimsy, yet it should work as a chain guard. But all right, guys, that was the quick install on a swing arm mounted license plate bracket. I will be getting a light for it soon, but just because we're trying to get ready for that race, I really just don't feel like messing with it right now. So all right, guys, as always, I hope you like this video. If you do, please give it a thumbs up. Drop any comments. You want to know anything more about the channel, and even too, if you want to know anything about the race event that's coming up here in about 2 weeks, it will be at Cecil County Dragway down in Maryland. But we're going to be racing. We're going to be seeing if we can crank this baby into the nines, which now that I can launch her harder with the swing arm, it's going to be possible. All right, guys, as always, don't forget to subscribe along with hitting that little bell next to it for notifications on the newest videos that come out. As always, ride safe, ride smart, always wear a helmet, and I'll see you on the next one. Thank you.